Dear students, I hope you all are fine. Today in this session we are going to cover chapter number 6, 7, 8 and 9 of your general knowledge. Chapter number 6 is birds that cannot fly. Chapter number 7 is popular abbreviations. Chapter number 8 is sobriquet and chapter number 9 is first in India. So let's continue our educational journey together with chapter number 6. Chapter number 6 is birds that cannot fly. Students, do you know that? How do birds fly? Yes, exactly. Birds fly with the help of their wings. But do you know that there are many birds which cannot fly? The birds which cannot fly are known as flightless birds. And today we are going to discuss about some of the flightless birds. The first flightless bird is ostrich. Ostrich is the largest living bird on earth. It can grow up to the height of 2.75 meters and can gain weight up to 150 kilograms. This bird is found in the continent of Africa. And its egg is the largest egg in the world. Students, do you want to see the picture of ostrich? This is an ostrich, the largest living bird on earth. The second flightless bird is emu. Emu is the second largest living bird in the world. It can grow up to the height of 1.7 meters and can gain weight up to 45 kilograms. This bird is found in Australia and it is a very good swimmer. This bird has one more unique feature, that is, it has two sets of eyelids, one for blinking the eyes and second for keeping the dust out. Now let us see the picture of emu. This is an emu, the second largest living bird in the world. The next flightless bird is kiwi. Kiwi is the smallest of all flightless birds. It is only as big as a hen. This bird is found in New Zealand. It has no tail, no feathers, but it has whiskers, just like a cat. It is the only bird in the world which has nostrils at the end of its beak. Now let us see the picture of kiwi. This is a kiwi, the smallest of all flightless birds. The next flightless bird is penguins. The penguins live in very cold places. They are found in Antarctica, which is in southern hemisphere. These birds raise their young ones on the ice caps. They can use their feathers as flippers while swimming in the water. Now let us see the picture of penguin. This is a penguin. Now students, let's recall what we have learned by doing the book exercise. Here, the pictures of flightless birds are given to you. You have to identify them and tell their names. So let's start. The first picture is of kiwi. Can you guess the name of the second flightless bird? Yes, it is ostrich. The third picture is of penguin. And the last picture is of emu. Now students, let's move on to the next chapter. The next chapter is chapter 7, popular abbreviations. Students, we often use abbreviations in our day-to-day lives. Like when you are working on a personal computer, you say, I am working on a PC. This PC is nothing but abbreviation or shortened form of personal computers. So, abbreviations are shortened forms of particular words or phrases. Now, let's do the book exercise. In this, some abbreviations are given to you and their full forms are also given. You have to match the abbreviations with their full forms. So let's start. The first is ATM. The full form of ATM is Automated Teller Machine. This machine helps the people to do banking transactions like withdrawing or depositing cash. The next is LCD. LCD stands for Liquid Crystal Display. The next is PIN. The full form of PIN is Postal Index Number. Each and every area has a unique PIN, which is basically a 6-digit code. IBM stands for International Business Machine. This is a company which manufactures computers. Next is HDFC. HDFC stands for Housing Development Finance Corporation. It is the name of a bank. Now next is JBL. JBL stands for James Bullough Lansing. It is basically an American company that manufactures audio equipments like headphones, loudspeakers, etc. WWW stands for World Wide Web. DVD stands for Digital Versatile Disc. PAN stands for Permanent Account Number. And RIP stands for Rest in Peace. Now let us move on to the next chapter. The next chapter is sobriquet. Many of us have a nickname which is given to us by our parents, friends, and relatives. But that nickname is an informal name, which is also known as sobriquet. So sobriquet is an informal nickname or an unofficial title given to a person or a place. And the word sobriquet has been derived from French language. Now students, look at this. It is the capital of Rajasthan. It has pink colored houses and buildings all across the city. Now here I am talking about Jaipur. And the sobriquet for Jaipur is the pink city. Now next is, its national animal is kangaroo. These animals are found all across its continent. Can you guess which continent am I talking about here? Yes, I am talking about Australia. And the sobriquet for Australia is Land of the Kangaroos. Next is, it has thousands of lakes spread all across the country. Now here, I am talking about Finland. And the sobriquet for Finland is Land of a Thousand Lakes. Students, I hope you all are familiar of him. He is Sachin Tendulkar. Do you know he started playing cricket when he was just 16 years old? He is the youngest ever test cricket player in India. And the sobriquet for him is the Little Master. Next is, it is the capital of Karnataka, though it is one of the tech hubs of India. That means it has many IT companies, but still the place is full of greenery. Here, I'm talking about Bengaluru. And sobriquet for Bengaluru is Garden City of India. Next is, the sobriquet of this place has been given by a Greek historian, Herodotus. This kingdom is dependent on the annual flooding of the Nile River for its survival and fertility. Now here I am talking about Egypt. And the sobriquet for Egypt is the gift of the Nile. Now let us move on to the next chapter. Next chapter is First in India. Students, in this, few pictures have been given to you and one hint related to each picture has also been given. You have to identify and tell the name of the person using that given hint. So let's start. First woman IAS in India. She was Anna Rajam George. First woman IPS in India. Can you guess her name? Yes, she is Kiran Bedi. First licensed pilot in India. J.R.D. Tata. First Nobel Prize winner in India. He was Rabindranath Tagore. First Home Minister of India. He was Sardar Vallabh Bhai Patel. First President of Indian National Congress. He was W.C. Banerjee. First Indian to travel in space, Squadron Leader Rakesh Sharma. First Miss World of India, Rita Faria. First Miss Universe of India, Sushmita Sen. That's all for today, students. Thank you and have a nice day.